turn to the next page, this is the revenues expenses for the transportation fund. About halfway down the page, you had total revenues of about $1.5 million. That's up about $260,000. The majority of the change is up in your local section, real estate taxes. They were about $654,000, or an increase of $250,000 for the year. You did increase the tax rate from 10 cents to 20 cents there in 2017. So that accounts for the largest increase in your real estate taxes. Total expenditures were about $2 million. Again, in 2016, about $2 million, so a slight increase of $26,000 for the year. That left you with a deficiency for the year of about $482,000. You transferred in about $1.1 million from the working cash fund, and leaves you with an increase for the year of about $632,000 and an ending fund balance of about $1.2 million in your transportation fund. If you turn the next page, it's a line graph comparing operating funds, total revenues and expenditures. You see the blue line represents revenues, the red line represents your expenditures. As you can see from the graph, the previous four fiscal years, the district had been deficit spending. In 2017, due to the significant reductions in expenditures for the operating funds of about 8%, and a small increase in revenues, which was about 2%, the operating funds showed a surplus. So as you can see, you had to make some tough decisions with some cuts, and it has paid off with the financial condition of the district. If you then turn to the last page, this is just a graph of the operating funds fund balances. As you can see, in 2012, the total fund balances of the operating funds were about $22.8 million. As you can see from the downward trend of the line, obviously if you have deficit spending, you're spending down your reserves and your fund balance. So at 2017, you had about $15.7 million. In fund balances, so over the last 5 to 6 years, the fund balance has decreased about $7.1 million due to the deficit spending or spending down of your reserves. So during the year, the district made significant reductions, which resulted in a surplus for the year. At June 30th, 2017, the district had adequate cash reserves, see from the first page in the slide. Given the uncertain financial condition and situation of the state and what they're going to do with their funding of general state aid and the rest of their categorical payments, you do receive about 45% of your total operating fund revenues from state sources. So it is a significant portion of your funding for the district. I would just suggest that due to that uncertainty with the state, that you continue to monitor and control your costs as much as you possibly can. You are fairly limited on generating new revenues, so you have to, and without knowing what the state's going to do, really the main thing you control are your expenses. So, again, very good job for this year. It's nice to see a nice turnaround here in the financial. Does anybody have any questions or comments?
Thank you, Mr. Hilton. Does anybody have any questions?
I'm not sure who it gets directed to, if it's an audit or a finance question. On page 2, where it says the excess, and you highlighted that to us, it went from, in 2007, we had budgeted a deficiency of a little over $1.5 million. Our actual was close to being positive of $2 million. What accounts for that a swing of close to $3 million? Is that a budgetary question? Does that make any sense?
Right. So there were additional reductions that were made throughout the year. We chose through attrition not to replace certain positions.
During school year?
Yes, like during the last budgeting cycle. The other thing too is that we're very conservative when we're budgeting for our categoricals and also for our GSA payments, because we knew the state at the time when we entered into this budget was behind about $8 million in bills. So we weren't entirely sure, so we took that into account that we would not receive all of our general state aid payments, which thankfully we did, and we did receive 3 out of the 4 categoricals, which was more than we had budgeted for. So that accounts for...
That's not the revenue issue, the amount of money we received. I was questioning the, well, the excess of the, okay.
Yeah.
Right, and one other thing, there was a refund right around the, I think after the end of the year, from the special ed co-op, Knox Warren, of $300,000-$400,000, which was not expected.
That was one of the categoricals. And our CPPRT money was actually up last year as well.
It was up about $172,000.
Unfortunately, this year they're reducing it by 23%, so we won't see that again this year.
One more question. He highlighted on the fifth page that we made that transfer in the working cash fund. When does that get paid back?
It doesn't, it's a permanent transfer.
Oh.
Yeah, the board would have had to approve a resolution to abate a portion of the working cash fund.
So we borrowed and we sold working cash funds to support the transportation fund over $1 million.
There were monies in working cash before, mm-hmm. So we used the working cash bond money that we had borrowed a couple of years ago to do health and safety improvements. These were existing funds that were already in there.
This is the transportation fund I was asking about.
Correct. But I'm saying there was monies in the working cash fund prior to selling those working cash bonds 18 months ago, 20 months ago. We used that money for health and safety repairs. So there was money in there prior to selling those working cash bonds. That's, in essence, the money that we transferred into transportation. Because we levy for working cash every year, so that money builds up over time.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Feel free to contact me anytime you come up with any questions later on.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
What I will say is that I know that at times, sitting out in the audience or reading comments about how the district is now in a better place financially can sting and fall hard in times, because we did have to go through so many cuts in order to get there. But I want folks to understand and recognize that part of our role as a board is to make sure that our school finances are in a situation so that we are able to continue on providing education to our school children, but also so that we're in a rating area so that if we need to move forward to do any other kind of work on loans or bonds or things, that we're in a position that we're able to do that. So while it may sound harsh, or it may sound as if, oh wow, the district's saving money or cutting positions, it's not an even balance. It's not as if because we now have some cash on hand or that our surplus has increased just a tad bit that means that we're flush with money. We're still in a precarious situation. We're talking about the fact that the reserves that Mr. Hilton referenced, we were at a position of $22 million in our reserves. And we spent down to $15 million before we made any cuts. And that was the bottom that we could do, because we have to have enough working cash on hand and enough in our financial capacity to fund the district and pay salaries and et cetera if in the case of any crisis. So I just want to be clear on that. While it can sound harsh and we're getting praise because we made reductions in order to be at a financial gain here, it's not that it's lost on us what it took us to get there. And I just wanted to say that. Thank you, Mr.
Yeah, actually, your fund balance was down at the end of last year, 2016, to under $14 million. So without the surplus this year, you would have been in a lot worse financial condition.
I got a quick question concerning that. What would be a safe number that we should strive for as far as not leaving
I typically recommend that at a minimum, your fund balance would be 25% of your annual expenditures. That's a minimum amount, so obviously the higher level you can have would be better. That's about 90 days worth of expenditures.
The 25% would be 90 days?
Yeah, approximately. Jen commented, you still have not received your fourth categorical payments from the state, and who knows if you're going to ever receive them. So,
right.
You know, the state did have another budget problem, and they weren't paying general state aid as they threatened, and they could only operate for so long if you didn't have the reserves there. So.
Right. Is that typically what other districts have, about like 25%? Or?
It's kind of all over the board. I mean, some are a lot less, some are a lot more. And I've seen a lot of the rural districts that I work on are kind of at a lower level than more of the urban districts.
Well, and I would also say that districts that are